Welcome back. As we promised, we are going to talk about the Egyptian economy and in particular about how the Egyptian economy was able and is able, and inshallah we are going to continue in a positive manner to meet or to face the repercussions of COVID-19. COVID-19 pandemic, as we all know, it's a global crisis which is facing the whole world. Today, for example, Joe Biden, the American president-elect, was naming those who are going to be responsible for the economic circle, and in just a few hours to come, we are going to know in person who is going to do so, for what, for reviving or trying to revive the American economy, meaning that this is a global issue. But what about here? What about the statements which were said yesterday by His Excellency Minister of Finance, Dr. Mohammad Maith, about the Egyptian ability to reduce its deficit and to achieve surplus? To shed more light on this, we are very much delighted to have with us via phone our economic expert, Dr. Hani Abdel Fattouh. A very good morning to you, sir.
Good morning to you and dear viewers.
Sir, we were speaking about the statements which were said, as I said yesterday, by His Excellency Dr. Mohammad Maith, Minister of Finance. First, I'd like to know or to listen from you some elaboration regarding decreasing the deficit and to achieve surplus. Was it expected? Was it the fruitful implementation of the economic reform program which started earlier, which enabled us to meet these targets, or we need to know more?
Well, let me tell you that the important issue here to achieve and sustain the economic growth in Egypt is the stability, the political stability and the macroeconomic stability. As you may agree, Egypt has long been crucial to the development in the Middle East and North Africa, and Egypt is actually pioneering many industries in the MENA region, and despite the repercussions of the COVID-19, Egypt is still sustaining positive growth. From year 17 until the coronavirus crisis hit, Egypt's positive growth story was successfully pushed by increased macroeconomic and political stability. And the key word here is the political stability, and I will illustrate more on that just in a moment. Just to show how important one important aspect here is achieving the security and stability in Egypt. The comprehensive anti-terrorism operations launched in year 2018 caused severe damages to terrorist infrastructure and helped to restore the chances of tourism sectors. And that's why we see that before the crisis, the tourism sector has achieved historic results and revenues. After all, I would like to note that the successful economic reform initiated by the government nearly 4 years ago is due to the political stability and mutual trust between the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and the Egyptian people. So Egypt, as Dr. Maith said yesterday in the statement, is achieving well, and it expected that the coming 4 years of the projections of the economic progress and growth will continue to show more results, good results.
Yes, Dr. Abdel Fattouh, but you know, the layman in the street, when he listens to some statements like that, maybe the first thing to come to his or her mind, of course, is the mega national projects. The state is going in parallel with continuing with the national mega projects in the same time, maintaining the stability of the economy. Some would say that this is a little bit contradictory. How we are moving on with the strategic national projects and in the same time maintaining our economy's stability, increasing the deficit, achieving surplus. In your opinion, how this was being done on the ground?
In fact, this exactly is the striking a good balance between achieving the progress in the economy and yielding more results from the economic reforms. This is in one hand. On the other hand, continuing with the mega projects. And by the way, the mega projects, the expenditures on the mega projects cause the economy to achieve positive results, because the expenses affect multiple business sectors, in constructions, in trade, and in transportations, and lower the unemployment rate.
Yes.
So what? And lowering the unemployment rate, and
yeah.
As you see in the last quarter, the unemployment rate has slightly improved, and now it stands at 9% in the first quarter, the second quarter of the year. So it is a difficult equation, and the government does its best to strike the right balance between achieving the growth objectives and at the same time alleviating poverty, so that the lay or the average citizen would not feel devastated by the repercussions or the negative impact of the economic program.
Sir, since we mentioned the national mega projects, we should also speak about small and medium projects, as there is no economy which can depend only on mega projects, but the micro, macro, small, medium sized projects are equally important and sometimes even more important. Her Excellency Dr. Naveen Al-Qabbaj, before being the Minister of Industry and Trade, she was the one responsible for the SMEs, and she knew and in detail the map of it here in Egypt, and maybe because of this she was very much it was very much easier for her to run these projects and to know in detail about each, about the ratios, about which projects are in need of help, everything, and in detail. Would you please, sir, elaborate on the importance of the micro, macro, small, and medium enterprises and their share in pushing forward the Egyptian economy, particularly in this very critical period?
As rightfully said, small and medium enterprises are very crucial in the growth of any economy, because of the state or the government cannot be the one and only player in the ground field. The private sector, in general, by large, is responsible for creating more more jobs in the economy. And boosting the SME sector is very crucial and has always been a priority for the government in the last few years. And that's why the government and the agencies responsible for boosting the small and medium enterprises and microfinance initiatives all have been working in tandem to provide finance and technical assistance to this sector. So it is expected that the government will continue its efforts to boost SMEs and make all efforts to make this sector successful in providing more jobs in the economy.
Sir, before asking the common question, I should apologize. I said Dr. Naveen Al-Qabbaj, Her Excellency Dr. Naveen Al-Qabbaj is the Minister of Social Solidarity. I meant, of course, Dr. Naveen Gama. Sir, returning back to our issue and speaking about the reports which were released recently, whether by the World Bank or by the IMF, praising the Egyptian economy's performance. To what extent we should take these reports into consideration and making sure that what we are doing here inside Egypt is a message sent to the whole world, and to make all these international bodies in general and big economies as well have confidence in the Egyptian economy and would depend on them to be the gate for their products, for instance, whether to the Middle East region or to the African continent?
Well, it's not only the World Bank or the IMF who praised the progress of the Egyptian economy It's also, I would like also to mention here that there was a recent report by the by Fitch Rating Agency. This report sees Egypt is on track to grow at an average 4% clip over each of the coming 4 years, which would give Egypt a ranking in the MENA region as the highest real GDP growth rate from 2020 to 2024. It's the IMF, the World Bank, Deutsche Bank, and the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development who have strong expectations about the growth of the Egyptian economy. And I see that these reports make Egypt a place or a focus for foreign investors.
An investment hub, if I may say so.
An investment hub, hopefully, we see more foreign direct investment in the coming years.
With this positive note, sir, Dr. Hani Abu Al-Futouh, I would thank you very much for your input and wish you a very good day. And by this, we come to the end of this segment. But right after the short break, we are going to turn back with more. Stay tuned only on Al TV International.